Today's another day of fact or fiction, where I'm going to go through a statement that somebody has made or a question that somebody has asked and quickly just answer how that is fact or fiction. Howdy, welcome to Family History Fanatics, where we love helping you climb your family tree and have fun along the way. If you're new to genetic genealogy, chances are you have tons of questions. Be sure to check out the link in the description below for our free guide to the 5 most common DNA questions that we have answers to. Today's fact or fiction is DNA tests can identify a specific location where your ancestors live. And this is probably one that is what gets most people into DNA testing. They see the commercials about finding out what your heritage is, your ethnicity, what groups you belong to, or at least your ancestors belong to. And that's really, I think, where the majority of people start with the DNA testing. So let's get down to DNA tests, whether DNA tests can identify specific locations your ancestors have lived. Now, various companies make claims as to how accurate they are. Just in general, I'm going to say that this is fiction, sort of, because it depends on where or how specific of a location we're talking about. If we're talking about a specific continent, well, I'm going to have to agree, because there's actually enough difference that we see between Europeans and Asians and Americans and Africans that we can identify a DNA profile for those different continents. Now, that doesn't mean that everybody from that continent has that DNA profile. It just means that, hey, there's certain markers that are far more prevalent in that place than another place. But then we get down to smaller and smaller levels. And this is really what people are wanting is, hey, which of the African tribes am I from? Or what country in Europe were my ancestors from? Or, you know, anything like this. And that's where it gets to be a little bit more problematic. Two reasons. Well, two big reasons. There's probably lots of reasons. The first one is we are using modern DNA, in other words, yours, to compare to other people who are also modern. In other words, the reference sets that they use to define what is Northwest European DNA, what is East African DNA, those DNA sets are all from people who live there now. Now, one of the criteria for those reference sets is that their grandparents also had to have lived there. Sometimes their great-grandparents, all of their great-grandparents had to have lived there. And so we can reliably go back 2 or 3 generations and say, okay, yeah, this looks like that. What we're not comparing to is we're not comparing to a few hundred years ago DNA. For instance, I have a line of ancestors that are Dutch, Northwest European, and they have been in America since the 1600s, basically when the Dutch first settled in New Amsterdam and up to Fort Orange, they were part of that. 300 years ago, my Dutch ancestors were not from the Netherlands. They were from America. It wasn't until 400 or 500 years ago that they were from the Netherlands. So comparing my DNA now with their DNA, we would see that, hey, this DNA looks like it's from the Americas. And that's why companies really take out all these colonial nations like the United States, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, except for the native populations. Because just in a few hundred years of colonialism, we've had large groups of people that really have completely changed the DNA profile of an area. We're not comparing our modern DNA to, I don't want to say postmodern or ancient DNA, but older DNA. We're comparing it to modern DNA as far as a reference set. And because of their known genealogy histories, that gets us back about 100 years. But that's where the second problem comes in, is the amount of migration that has happened in the human family over the centuries. Now, I mentioned this because when we're talking about my Dutch ancestors, the main surname that ends up connecting with me is Quick. Quick is actually not a Dutch surname. It is an English surname. And back, I believe, in the 1500s, you know, when there was a major war, there's lots of wars in Europe at that time, but there was plenty of English soldiers that were stationed fighting whatever over in the continental part of Europe, and some of them stayed. And that is probably where this Quick surname for the Dutch came from, is actually from English. But if we go back further, of course, we find different surnames. We have the Norman invasion into England with the we have earlier with the Angles and the Saxons invasion, the Viking invasion. So that's just what we know on a broad scale, just in Europe. We have these groups moving all over. So is it unusual to find, let's say, Scandinavian DNA in France? Well, no, because we know that the Vikings, you know, invaded France. We certainly find it in England and in Ireland. But likewise, we also find English DNA in other parts of Europe. We find Italian DNA elsewhere. Now, that doesn't mean that everybody in those groups all has that, but it's not unusual to find something like that, that, yeah, your ancestors were from that place maybe at some point, but they were also from a lot of other places. And so pinpointing specific locations, I don't put much weight in that. Basically because we really don't know what the DNA profile of the people that lived there 500 years ago was. We don't know what it was 1,000 years ago. We can assume that it's very similar to the ones that live there now that have had their great-grandparents. But if you imagine, hey, if your great-grandparents were all born there, but their parents were immigrants from somewhere else, well, now you've got a different DNA that has been put into that group. And so now you're classifying something as English DNA, when really it should be classified as Dutch DNA or Polish DNA or Scandinavian DNA. So there's a lot of complications in that. And that's why I think that this is a fiction. I don't think that this is a fact. I don't put a lot of weight in companies that are saying they can pinpoint a specific location of where your DNA is from, because I don't think that we have the amount of data or even the type of data that we need to make that conclusion. If you want to learn more about DNA, why don't you try looking at this video up here? But if you want to learn something about researching a particular record set, then why don't you try this video down below? I think my voice like broke there. Let's try that again.